Waves and Optics Session 8. Let's now move on to Fourier series. Introduction. Fourier's theorem is one of the most fundamental theorems in mathematics. It's very useful in physics and electronics. For example, to understand or describe the various modes of vibration of systems and in separation of noise from information signals, etc. Statement of Fourier's theorem. Fourier's theorem can be stated as follows. Any periodic function y is equal to f of omega t of wavelength lambda can be regarded as made up of simple harmonic curves of definite amplitudes, phases, and periods, the wavelength of the components being in the ratio lambda is to lambda by 2 is to lambda by 3, etc. Or the frequencies in the ratio n is to 2n is to 3n, etc. Mathematical form of Fourier's theorem. Fourier's theorem can be expressed as follows. Y is equal to f of omega t is equal to a naught plus a1 cos of omega t plus epsilon 1 plus a2 cos of 2 omega t plus epsilon 2 up to ar cos of r omega t plus epsilon r. Or y is equal to f of omega t, which is equal to a naught plus sigma r is equal to 1 to infinity ar cos of r omega t plus epsilon r. Let's consider this as equation 1. Here a1, a2, a3, etc. are the amplitudes and epsilon 1, epsilon 2 and epsilon 3, etc. are the initial phases of the components. We know that ar cos of r omega t plus epsilon r is equal to ar cos of epsilon r cos of r omega t minus ar sin epsilon r sin of r omega t, which is equal to ar cos of r omega t plus br sin of r omega t. Let's consider this as equation 2, where ar is equal to ar cos of epsilon r and br is equal to minus ar sin of epsilon r. Using equation 2 in equation 1, we may write y is equal to f of omega t, which is equal to a naught plus sigma r is equal to 1 to infinity ar cos of r omega t plus br sin of r omega t. Let's consider this as equation 3. This is the mathematical form of Fourier's theorem. Here, a naught, ar and br are referred to as Fourier coefficients. Let us now evaluate these coefficients. Initially, let us evaluate Fourier's coefficient a naught. Integrating equation 3 over a complete cycle of wave, that is between t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t, integral 0 to t y dt is equal to integral 0 to t a naught dt plus integral 0 to t ar cos of r omega t plus br sin of r omega t dt, which is equal to a naught t plus 0. This implies the second integral becomes 0. Therefore, a naught is equal to 1 by t times integral 0 to t y dt. Let's consider this as equation 4. Now, let's evaluate Fourier coefficient ar. To evaluate ar, we shall multiply equation 4 by cos of r omega t dt throughout and integrate. That is, integral 0 to t y cos of r omega t dt is equal to a naught times integral 0 to t cos of r omega t dt plus ar times integral 0 to t cos square of r omega t dt plus br times integral 0 to t sin of r omega t into cos of r omega t dt. Here obviously the first and the third integrals vanish and we are left with integral 0 to t y cos of r omega t dt is equal to ar integral 0 to t cos square of r omega t dt, which is equal to ar times integral 0 to t 1 plus cos of 2r omega t divided by 2 times dt, which can be simplified as ar into t by 2. Therefore, ar is equal to 2 by t times integral 0 to t y cos of r omega t dt. Let's consider this as equation 5. Now, evaluation of Fourier coefficient Br. In order to evaluate Br, let us multiply equation 4 by sine of r omega t dt throughout and integrate. That is, integral 0 to t y sine of r omega t dt is equal to a naught times integral 0 to t sine of r omega t dt plus ar times integral 0 to t cos of r omega t sine of r omega t dt plus br times integral 0 to t sine square of r omega t dt. Here the first two integral reduces to 0 so that we are left with integral 0 to t y sine of r omega t dt is equal to br times integral 0 to t sine square of r omega t dt, which can be rewritten as br times integral 0 to t 1 minus cos of 2r omega t by 2 times dt, which is equal to br into t by 2. Therefore, br can be expressed as 2 by t times integral 0 to t y sine of r omega t dt. Let us now consider this as equation 6. Using equations 4, 5 and 6 in equation 3, we get the final form of Fourier's theorem, that is y is equal to f of omega t, which is equal to 1 over t times integral 0 to t y dt plus 2 by t summation of r is equal to 1 to infinity integral 0 to t y cos square of r omega t dt plus 2 by t summation r is equal to 1 to infinity integral 0 to t y sin square of r omega t dt. Let's consider this as equation 7. So this is the final form of Fourier's theorem. Hope this concept is clear to you. Thank you.